There are about 1.5 billion people worldwide infected with soil-transmitted helminths. In the southern United States and the Appalachians, hookworm infection rates reached 40% of the population. In children with atopic dermatitis, parasitosis is detected in almost 53% of cases. From the liver, other coccus can grow through the diaphragm into the lung. Hi everyone! Do you have parasites in your body? No? I wouldn't be so sure if I were you. Parasitic worms or helminths are very common. According to the WHO, there are about 1.5 billion people worldwide infected with soil-transmitted helminths. And if we count helminths transmitted in other ways, the number is much higher. What are parasites? A parasite is an organism that lives on or in a host and receives food from the host or at the expense of the host. The word parasite comes from two Greek words, para about plus sitos, nutrition, literally a freeloader, one who feeds at the expense of another. In ancient Greece, this was the name given to people who received a special pension for services to the state and lived in special boarding houses on state support, parasitaria. But the real meaning of this word was brought by the Romans. It was they who began to call parasites people who don't have their own livelihood and live at the expense of others. I wonder who they remind you of. Several hundred species of helminths from 250 to 360 are known that can cause various diseases in humans. Moreover, warm countries are loved not only by us people, but also by helminths. The warmer the climate and the lower the socio-economic status of the country, the greater the number and diversity of helminthiasis. So it is believed that there are an average of two types of helminths per inhabitant of the African continent. In Asia and Central America, approximately 1.5 each. However, parasitic infections also affect persons living in developed countries, including the United States. In the 1980s, in the southern United States and the Appalachians, hookworm infection rates reached 40% of the population. Little research has been done on this topic in the United States in recent years, and completely in vain. In Russia, about 1 million patients with helminthiasis are registered annually. 90% of them are children and adolescents. However, leading infectious disease specialists say that the infection rate of the population is much higher. So, quickly go through the main syndromes in parasitosis. Allergic syndrome. Helminth antigens and their metabolic products can cause sensitization, that is, a specific hypersensitivity of the body. This sensitization or allergization is manifested by the following symptoms: fever, edema, eosinophilia, increased levels of eosinophils in the blood, allergic inflammation of the intestinal wall, bronchi and bile ducts, muscle and joint pain, lymphadenopathy, and of course a skin rash or urticaria. Parasitosis should be suspected in the first place in the presence of any rashes on the skin and mucous membranes. According to Russian scientists, in children with atopic dermatitis, parasitosis is detected in almost 53% of cases. Moreover, often exacerbation of rashes occurs during the migration of helminths. So, before you buy another anti-dermatitis cream, the problem may not be tangerines, eggs, nuts, or other food that you ate. Think about it. Astheno-neurotic syndrome. Parasites adversely affect the state of the human nervous system. For example, roundworms secrete a waste product, ascarone, which has not only an allergic effect on the body, but also a toxic effect on the brain. Under the influence of parasites, behavioral reactions change, the ability to learn decreases, symptoms such as headaches, dizziness, weakness, increased fatigue, sleep disturbances, hysterical seizures, irritability, neurotic states, sometimes even enuresis and encopresis appear. So folks, don't blame all your tantrums on PMS or work stress. Maybe your parasites are just in mating season. Deficiency syndrome. Parasites living in humans actively use vitamins, minerals, and nutrients from food to carry out their life activity. With parasitosis, a person's hair becomes thinner and falls out, nails exfoliate, the skin condition worsens, sore spots appear in the corners of the mouth, and anemia develops. Some helminths, such as whipworm or hookworm, pierce the intestinal wall and feed on the host's blood. In addition, these comrades clearly don't leave the human body to go to the toilet. They do all their toilet work inside the human body. This leads to dysfunction of the gastrointestinal tract and dysbacteriosis. Concomitant intestinal dysbacteriosis exacerbates iron deficiency and vitamin deficiency conditions. So if you drank 1-2 jars of vitamin supplements and you don't see any effect, think about it. What else you don't see in your body? Abdominal syndrome. In 75% of cases, parasitosis is accompanied by various lesions of the gastrointestinal tract. Intestinal helminthiasis can cause abdominal pain, bloating, a sensation of seething in the abdomen, nausea and stool disorders, constipation, diarrhea, alternating constipation and diarrhea. Abdominal syndrome in parasitosis is associated with sluggish inflammation of the intestinal wall, impaired secretion of biologically active peptides and enzymes that affect peristalsis, that is, contraction of the intestinal wall, and the development of dysbacteriosis due to parasite toxins. With enterobiosis, the processes of absorption and digestion of food products are disrupted, and the acidity of gastric juice decreases. Roundworms secrete inhibitors of trypsin and chymotrypsin. These are pancreatic enzymes. As a result, the absorption of nutrients worsens. Lactose intolerance can develop. So if your stomach hurts, then maybe someone really lives there. Respiratory syndrome. Cough can be associated both with an allergic reaction of the walls of the respiratory tract, hyperproduction of mucus, and with the direct migration of larvae and their coughing up, such as our beloved roundworms. Their larvae grow precisely in the tissues of the lungs, molt there, then rise with sputum through the bronchi to the pharynx, cough up and then re-swallow. And such a person can be treated unsuccessfully for years for coughing. Let's take another parasite, Alveococcus. Oncospheres of Alveococcus enter the alimentary canal through the mouth and settle mainly in the right lobe of the liver. From the liver, Alveococcus can grow through the diaphragm into the lung. Patients complain of chest pains and cough with mucus sanguineus or purulent sputum, sometimes stained with bile. Yes, parasites travel through the human body more than some people travel through the city they live in. The life of many parasites is very rich. They go through several stages of their development and have a strong influence on almost all human organs and systems. The difficulty lies in the fact that children and adults rarely have pronounced symptoms of parasitosis. As you have already seen, these symptoms are non-specific and can occur in a person without parasites. Did you find any symptoms from this video in yourself? Write in the comments below and don't forget to protect your body and mind from parasites.